Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sajita, and if you're new here, I put up daily content on makeup, skincare, and hair care as well. So if you're interested, please subscribe to my channel and let's get started. So today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys just the three products you need to have a perfect skincare routine. This is great for anyone who's a beginner into skincare and you're struggling to kind of know and educate yourself on what products you need. In order to begin, first we need to make sure you know what type of skin you have. So there's typically oily, dry, combination skin, normal skin, or sensitive skin. So how you can test what kind of skin you have is after you take a shower, just step out and pat dry your skin and leave it for an hour and see how your skin reacts. Is it producing a lot of oil, or do you feel like super dry and tight, or do you get really irritated from just touching your face? Does it get red sometimes, or is it just kind of like you're fine, like nothing's wrong type of thing? Or are you getting like oily on the nose and T-zone area and feeling dry on the cheeks? So just by analyzing these things, you can know what type of skin you have. So again, if you're feeling really like you're shiny, then you have oily skin. If you're feeling really taut and tight, that means you have dry skin. Or if you have a combination of both, then there you have it, you have combination skin. And if you easily get irritated and red cheeks or just redness in general, then you might have sensitive skin. And if nothing really happens, you're not feeling any sort of like extreme of either ends, and you probably have just normal skin. So the first product you need is a cleanser. A cleanser is useful to, obviously wash your face every day. I like to wash my face twice a day. If you don't wear a ton of product or makeup, you don't have to wash it in the morning, but definitely do wash it at night, every night. And there are three different types of cleansers that I would like to categorize them into. First one is being a hydrating cleanser, and that's for someone who has very dry skin and you don't want to feel stripped of all your oils from just washing your face. So a hydrating cleanser, like my favorite Crave Beauty Matcha Hemp Cleanser, is the perfect one. It removes all your makeup, dirt, oil, but at the same time, you don't feel stripped or really tight after washing your face. And the smell is great. It smells like matcha, or green tea. So I really do love the scent of this. But also, the Matcha Hemp Cleanser is great for sensitive skin as well. I've tried it myself for sensitive, or whenever I'm feeling sensitive or irritated, and has not, irritated my skin any worse. And the second type of cleanser that I began using with is a gentle, like very, very, very basic cleanser. And that's really suitable for someone who has sensitive skin like me. And I started off by using the First Aid Beauty Cleanser, and there's like super basic, but at the same time, creamy, doesn't have any fragrance, and it's hydrating as well. So you're not getting that added like matcha-ness from the Matcha Hemp Cleanser, but at the same time, you're getting exactly what you need. And it doesn't smell bad, but it doesn't have like any sort of irritating ingredients or scent. Third type of cleanser is like your normal cleanser. That's a foamy cleanser that's perfect for anyone with oily or normal skin. My favorite one is the Youth to the People Superfood Antioxidant Cleanser. I think this is perfect for many skin types, but if you feel like you have extra dry skin or extra sensitive skin, I would avoid this just because I do have that kind of tight feeling after washing my face. But for me, it's kind of like that in-between stage where you don't feel stripped necessarily, but rather you're like, okay, I definitely like cleansed my face today kind of feeling. So I really like to use this cleanser at nighttime, especially if I wore makeup throughout the day. I feel like this really does get in there and get off all those leftover dirt as well. And since we're only using three products in the skincare routine, it's super important that you double cleanse with your cleanser. So I know there's a lot of talks about cleansing balms and oil cleanses, which is great if you're able to afford it or kind of, go into that maybe in the future. But to start off, to be super basic, just use that same cleanser twice. Just wash your face once and then wash it a second time. However, if you are wearing makeup, like lots of makeup, mascara and stuff, I would definitely encourage you to go into oil cleansing, because cleansing balms are the ones that truly, truly get off all your makeup and mascara and all that grime from the heavy makeup. But again, if you're someone who doesn't really wear a ton of makeup and you just want a simple skincare routine, just using your cleanser twice is perfectly good enough. So now the second product that you need is a moisturizer. And even no matter what skin type you have, you definitely do need a moisturizer in your skincare routine. Even if you have oily skin, you need a moisturizer. It's what's gonna protect your skin and keep it nice and hydrated throughout the day. So there are two types of moisturizers. I like to categorize them into lightweight and thick moisturizers. So a lightweight moisturizer that I like is the Tatcha Water Cream Moisturizer. It's very water-like, that once immediately touches my skin, it just kind of disappears and really does have that unique texture and feels like water. So this is perfect for anyone who has that oily skin and you're like, I don't want a ton of like extra glow to my skin. I just need that required amount of hydration. This is perfect. And there are some dupes for this product as well, like the Laneige Water Cream Bank, I believe that's what it's called. But I'll definitely, again, leave some more alternatives down in the description box. A second type of moisturizer that I like is the Biossance Omega Repair Cream. So that's a very thick moisturizer, and this is perfect for anyone who has dry or sensitive skin where you need that extra boost of hydration. I personally like to use the lightweight Tatcha one for the morning and then something more thick like the Biossance one for nighttime, because I want to feel that hydration overnight, and I typically tend to wake up feeling more like dry, so I've been starting to include more of a thick moisturizer in my routine. So again, totally up to you. Depending on your skin type, choose what's the best moisturizer for you, but please don't forget a moisturizer. You shouldn't forget any of these three products. These should be like your staple in your routine. Third and final product is sunscreen, or SPF. So I know lately there's been a lot of importance to sunscreen, and I couldn't agree more. We all need to be wearing tons and tons and tons of sunscreen. It's the most vital part of your everyday skincare routine. And let's say you're in a rush and you're just like only able to grab one product, grab a sunscreen. Like, that's the ultimate product that you need. And I'm gonna explain why you need a sunscreen in your routine. So an SPF, you know, the most basic thing that an SPF is gonna offer you is protection from the sun. All sorts of UV rays that the sun is gonna release, it's gonna be protected by wearing a sunscreen. So by wearing a sunscreen, you're gonna, you know, have those anti-aging benefits and not get as many wrinkles or sunspots. But at the same time, it's so important for us who have pigmented skin as well. So any sort of brown, darker, deep skin tones, we have to wear sunscreen as well, because it's going to protect you from having any hyperpigmentation or kind of worsening that scarring that you have from any sort of breakouts. So for example, when I was younger, I didn't know about wearing sunscreen. I would get a lot of hyperpigmentation from the sun, where it would just be like, you know, just patches of darkness on my skin. And I just thought that that had to do with like my eczema or sensitive skin, but it was actually just hyperpigmentation. So now there are two types of sunscreen. There's mineral sunscreen and chemical sunscreen. So chemical sunscreen is what's gonna be absorbed into your skin, and it's gonna kind of reflect that sunlight off. Whereas the mineral sunscreen is just gonna lay on top of your skin, and it's gonna reflect that rays and all that bad stuff out. And for us who have darker skin tones, it's really hard to find a good mineral sunscreen out in the market, just because a lot of the mineral sunscreen have a white cast over. Since it is sitting on top of your skin, there's always that purpley bluey tint, which tends to leave like a gray cast on our skin tones. However, there are a couple sunscreens on the market that I do like. There's the Biossance mineral sunscreen, as well as the First Aid Beauty mineral sunscreen, but I feel like there are flaws to these products because you need to use a lot of it in order to get the right amount of coverage, and the Biossance one is so thick that people tend to just not use enough. And as the First Aid Beauty one, it has a slight tint to it. It's like a peachy brown kind of tint. And again, it's super liquidy, so people tend to not use as much as they need to be. So then on the other hand, the options that we have are chemical sunscreens. And my two favorite chemical sunscreen right now are the Crave Beauty Beach Shield sunscreen. Doesn't leave any sort of white cast and is super lightweight, non-greasy, doesn't have a strong fragrance to it, and does its job. It's my favorite one right now. And the Super Goop Play Everyday Lotion Sunscreen has SPF 50. It's also one of my favorites. However, the fragrance in this is a little too overpowering for me. It's like kind of like a sunflower fragrance. So I personally don't love it for the face right now, but I do want to use the leftover on my body and anywhere else that I need it. So some of the requirements that you want to look for in a good sunscreen is that it has minimum SPF 30. So that's the, you know, the golden number. Anything above it is good too, but you know, you don't need to go crazy with it being like SPF 100. I feel like after a point, it's just all the same. But you definitely don't want to use an SPF that's under 30 because it's really pointless. Anything that says it has SPF 15 or 25 is not good enough. You need SPF 30. Another thing is that you don't want to get a moisturizer plus an SPF together in one bottle. I know there are several products that have moisturizer and SPF included, but personally, I don't like that because you need to be wearing a lot more SPF than moisturizer, so you don't really know how much sunscreen you are wearing when you combine it with moisturizer. So I like to keep those items separate, apply my moisturizer, and then apply my SPF separately. That way I can reapply it throughout the day as well. But talking about reapplying, it's super, super vital that you're reapplying your sunscreen every 2 hours, even when you're indoors or outdoors. And I would say reapply it every hour if you're outside in like the beach or the pool where you're like constantly in the sun. And also the most important part is that you're wearing enough sunscreen. So a lot of people just kind of like dab a little bit all over your face and you're like, okay, I wore sunscreen. No, you didn't. You need to be wearing 2 finger-sized amount of sunscreen. So that's almost like just covering this whole range right here and applying that all over your face, your neck, your ears as well, and above on top of your lips as well. If you don't have a lip balm that has SPF in it, just wear your sunscreen over your lips as well. And also, additionally, wear sunscreen anywhere else that your skin is exposed, like your arms, legs, anywhere, your back. Just don't feel like, I'm just gonna get a sunburn today. Like, sunburns are never fun, and you definitely want to avoid it by wearing tons and tons of sunscreen. Especially even when we're indoors right now, it is important that you're wearing sunscreen because, you know, sunlight is coming through all sorts of directions from your windows. But also your laptop, all your screens also have different UV rays that can affect your skin. That wraps up the video. I've shared with you guys the 3 products that you need to have the most basic but essential skincare routine. We started off with the cleanser, moisturizer, and ended off with an SPF. So I hope you guys found the tips and information that I shared today helpful. If you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments section below. And again, check the description box for links to products that I mentioned, but also add in some drugstore alternatives as well. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.